Now about 10% of the world is ice. That ice is melting, and fast. But what if all of the ice in the world melted? How would this affect humans and animals? Would where you live be underwater? Or would your region not be as badly affected? I'm Charlie and today we're going to look at what if all of Earth's ice melted. Before we get into it, why not subscribe and press the notification bell? If we keep burning fossil fuels indefinitely, global warming will eventually melt all of the ice in the world. This will raise the sea level by 216 feet, and this would mean every coastline in the world would change. Every country would dramatically be reduced in size. This means our continents would have new shorelines and inland seas. In North America, the entire Atlantic seaboard would vanish. Florida and the Gulf Coast would be underwater totally. In California, all that would remain is San Francisco's hills. They would become a cluster of islands, and the Central Valley would be a giant bay. The Gulf of California would stretch north past the latitude of San Diego. However, you wouldn't be able to see San Diego because it would be underwater too. So just imagine all of Miami totally underwater. Going over to Europe, unless you want to swim everywhere, London would be a simple memory. Even tall buildings like the Shard, the largest building in Europe, would collapse. That's because 60% of it would be underwater. Also, Tower Bridge would be a thing of the past. Venice, Italy, which is famous for its canals, would be totally submerged. The Netherlands and most of Denmark would also be under the sea. And the Mediterranean would have spilled into the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea. If all of Earth's ice melted, South America would be hit hard too. The Amazon Basin and the Paraguay River Basin would be overwhelmed by the Atlantic Ocean. This would wipe out areas like Buenos Aires, Argentina. Also, most of Uruguay and Paraguay would be gone. The best place to survive in South America would be in the mountainous areas. Because they go so high, they would not be underwater. These mountainous areas can be found in Central America and the Caribbean coast. Compared with other continents, Africa would actually get off pretty scot-free. Maybe that's like karma because they have so many problems right now. However, there not being any water in this hot climate would make much of Africa uninhabitable. Also, areas like Cairo, Egypt, would be swamped by the Mediterranean. In Asia, lots of China would be flooded. This means over 600 million Chinese would have to move south. The same is true for Bangladesh, a population of nearly 200 million. And lots of India would also be underwater too. Cambodia's mountains would become islands. That's because the rest of the entire country would flood. In Australia, most of where people live right now would be lost. Despite being a large country, most of Australia lives on the coastal strip. But this area where 4 out of 5 Australians live would cease to exist. They also couldn't live in their desert because it would be uninhabitable. And if we look at Antarctica, obviously being mostly ice, it would be hit very hard. 4/5 of all of the world's ice is in East Antarctica. But if all ice melted, this would pretty much disappear. West Antarctica would also disappear too. It's actually more vulnerable than East Antarctica. That's because most of it sits on a bedrock which is below sea level. Since 1992, it's lost around 65 million metric tons of ice every year. But what about us humans? If we found a safe place to live, would we survive? Well, unfortunately, all of the ice being melted would release a lot of CO2. And because this happened overnight, we'd start choking because of all of the CO2 in the air. But humans would not be as affected as animals. Especially sea animals, that is. Because of all of the added water, ocean currents would change direction. And because this happened overnight, the animals have not evolved. This would cause most polar and underwater animals to pass away, and likely go extinct forever. This would also affect humans because we would not have the same food supply. Farming and fishing industries would be totally destroyed. Any animals that did survive would have to migrate to a totally different climate. Places like deserts would also completely change. There would be heavy rainfall there because of the new climate. And areas like farms and rainforests, which need water, would dry out. This would also destroy the farming industry, meaning we'd have no food. This may cause a worldwide famine, taking out most of the human population. The sun would also get more moisture from the oceans because there's more water. This would cause more clouds in the sky and more natural disasters. This includes things like hurricanes, which would cause more floods because of the new water levels. Previously, tiny earthquakes, which we may not even notice, could cause tsunamis. And this would cause lots of people to move around. This kind of unprecedented migration of people would cause a shutdown worldwide. It would be incredibly complex, and governments would likely cease. It would then be every man for himself, and it may well be a post-apocalyptic landscape. But could this actually happen? Well, thankfully, all of the Earth's ice can't melt overnight. But if we keep burning fossil fuels indefinitely, it can happen. Scientists say it may take more than 5,000 years to melt all of the world's ice. But if carbon keeps being added to the atmosphere, then we may create an ice-free planet. Right now, the average temperature in the world is 15 degrees Celsius. That's around 58 degrees Fahrenheit. But if we had no ice, this would jump up to 27 degrees Celsius. That's around 80 Fahrenheit. So let's hope we focus on renewable energies and don't keep burning fossil fuels. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner. Do you think we will ever reverse the damage done to Earth? If you want some more amazing videos, check out my second channel. But as always, thank you for watching. There's some more videos you may like on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.